Hello, I'm Dr. Sriram Ramalingam, Medical Director, Pradnya Nethralaya, Artinagar, Bengaluru, specialized in cataract, glaucoma, squint, and refractive surgeries. Keratoplasty. What is keratoplasty? Keratoplasty is like an organ donation where the transparent cornea from a dead person is harvested and surgically placed in a person who has got the cornea that is affected. One should remember that there is no full eye transplant. Only the cornea, which is a transparent organ in the eye, which has got no blood vessels, can be transplanted. In keratoplasty, there are various types. They can be divided into therapeutic and optical. Therapeutic, as the name suggests, it is used to maintain the integrity of the eye, maybe because of loss of integrity may occur because of corneal ulcer or trauma. Optical keratoplasty is the one that is commonly used. In optical keratoplasty, there are various types. One is what is called as a penetrating keratoplasty, where the full cornea is transplanted. Or the other is what is called as a deep lamellar keratoplasty. And the last one is what is called as a desmoid stripping automated endothelial keratoplasty. Now coming to the indications of each. Indications of penetrating keratoplasty. As everybody knows, cornea has got various layers. The cornea becomes white for various reasons. And the innermost layer of the cornea gets affected, or anterior surface of the cornea gets affected. We require transplant the whole cornea. This is what is called as a penetrating keratoplasty. The indications are combined and endothelial and stromal diseases of the cornea. Severe corneal scarring because of various reasons, maybe form of a trauma or some infections, or following surgery or a condition called as bullous keratopathy, where the cornea gets damaged, or a condition called as keratoconus, which hydrops. So these are the indications where a full thickness cornea is transplanted from a dead person to a normal person. What are the disadvantages of penetrating keratoplasty? It's a lengthy procedure. Post-op, it takes a longer time to heal. In these conditions, just like in any other normal organ transplant, rejection of the graft is possible and sutures are placed in the eye, and the sutures may take time and cause irritation and may need to be removed over a period of time. Because of the presence of sutures, the refractive errors may go haywire and may have an abnormal astigmatism. Deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty. The next type. What are the indications of deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty? Maybe in the form of corneal ectasia like keratoconus, keratoglobus, and pellucid macular degenerations. Corneal dystrophies, or what is called as a stromal dystrophies like granular dystrophies, lattice dystrophies, or macular dystrophies. Scars from the previous injuries, which are not full thickness, they are superficial in layer, can have what is called as a dulk or deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty. Degenerations in the cornea like Salzmann's nodules or climatic degenerations, can all these are indications for dulk. Post refractive ectasia after LASIK surgery, one has got an ectasia, one can go what is called as a deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty. Contraindications, absolute endothelial dysfunctions, one need to go for a penetrating keratoplasty. Posterior dystrophies, where anterior surface is normal. The advantages of deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty are preservation of the host endothelium. The chance of rejections are very low, no requirement of the donor endotheliums, and better long-term graft survival as compared to penetrating keratoplasty, and easier follow-up. The disadvantage of deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty is surgically, it's a difficult technique as compared to penetrating keratoplasty, and occasionally the optical interface can lead to problems. The last is DSEC, or desmoid stripping automated endothelial keratoplasty, what is also called as endothelial keratoplasty. The indications are endothelial dystrophies like Fuchs, posterior polymorph dystrophy, bullous keratopathy where the anterior surface are still normal, endothelial failure because of trauma or inflammations, are conditions like what is called as an endothelial syndromes. What are the contraindications? Stromal opacities, keratoconus, corneal ectasia, hypertonic. Advantages is a rapid technique and recovery is very fast. What are the disadvantages? Technically very demanding procedure, potentially significant loss of donor endothelial can occur, and incidence of dislocation is very high. So when a person dies, the cornea is harvested. Two people can benefit from the cornea that is donated. Occasionally, more than two can also be used. Like if you do a DALC, one can use the other one for endothelial, another one for a penetrating. So even three or four persons will benefit. So very important that one of the commonest cause of the blindness in children is corneal blindness. So by eye donation, one can provide vision to various lot of children who are affected. Not only children, even adults whose livelihood depends upon it. So it's very important to spread the message of corneal donations. As I said, two corneas from a dead person can give visions to three or more people. So pass on this message. Donate your eyes. As I said, the whole eye is never removed. Only the cornea is removed and transplanted. So take home message, donate your eyes and save vision for others.